Nostalgia, as they say, is not what it used to be. This old photograph of a rather uninspiring building in downtown Ayr, on the west coast of Scotland, is of the original Ayr Ice Rink. Dull as it may have appeared, however, this local sporting venue had, and still has, a special place in the hearts of those from all around Ayr who were teenagers back then. It resounded weekly to the sounds of the 60s played by the original bands. This was because, during 1965 and 1966, the Ayr Ice Rink management, as well as providing their weekly ice hockey, ice figure skating and public ice sessions, also regularly brought to Ayr some of the very top bands of the 1960s. Organist Edward Johnstone, from Kilwinning, was a member of a well-known Ayrshire band during the Swinging Sixties. Eddie's band was the resident Ayr Ice Rink band on Wednesday evenings throughout 1966. Eddie put together this short video of his memories of playing the rink. His wonderful memorabilia and musical memories provide a fascinating insight into that golden era, including recalling some of the other local bands on the Ayr scene. Also highlighted are all those famous UK bands and characters Eddie met along the way to playing Ayr and beyond. The Kinks, the Troggs, Gino Washington and the Ram Jam Band, Chris Farlow and the Thunderbirds, Crispian St. Peters, DJ Stuart Henry and Jack McLaughlin, Collida producer, Claire Francis, American soul singer, Davy Jones, even Ayr's own Majorettes made an appearance on the old Ayr Ice Rink stage with Eddie's band in 1966. This old photograph is of Ballinmile Hospital, near Ayr, in the autumn of 1965. 17-year-old male nurse Edward was sitting his second year exams at the hospital, when he was visited at the male block dormitory by these four scruffy musicians. They were called the Hi-Fi Combo. They had formed 4 years earlier, as a show band, and told Eddie that they needed an organ player as they now wanted to play soul music. The band rehearsed in local halls for a few weeks, prior to traveling up to Cumnock where auditions were being held to select a band to join the German club circuit for a 3-month tour. The band was successful, and whilst waiting the call they began playing the Scottish circuit. This included Ayr Ice Rink, the Bobby Jones, also in Ayr, the Troon Concert Hall and Kilbenny Walker Hall. The guys decided that they really should try to look the part, dress-wise, and moved into their flower power phase. They decided to buy various brightly colored curtains, as in the Sound of Music children's clothes, and had them made into jackets. Here is a photograph of their Technicolor Dream jackets, in vivid black and white. Here also is a photograph of them pre-flower power. The 1st of January 1966. Radio Scotland 242, a pirate radio station, began broadcasting off the west coast near Ayr. The two top DJs were Quietly Spoken Stuart Henry, and the gregarious Jack McLaughlin. McLaughlin spent his entire show in pan loaf accent lambasting everything Scottish, as being hooch-a-chooch to music. The pirate radio station also produced a monthly glossy magazine called 242 Showbeat. Christ 5p. The magazine showcased all the top UK bands but also found time to promote the local bands as well. Eddie still has his own copy of one particular edition, mainly because he is in it. Here is the front cover. On the 25th of February 1966, the band travelled to Keelstar Palace to begin the first week of a 4-week tour. This was the same Star Club group that the Beatles had toured back in 1962. The club manager was an American singer called Davy Jones and the band reluctantly were also required to be his backing band each night. The band didn't feel quite so bad when he showed them this photograph of his backing band in 1962. On their return from Germany, the band were told that they, plus a band from Stirling called the Vikings, had secured a recording session with Polydor Records. The guys were told to travel to Denmark Street, London to record their first songs. Their producer was an American, based in the UK, called Claire Francis, who was also an excellent singer. Her songs, But I Don't Care, and I Got My Own Thing Going, highlight perfectly the sounds of the 60s. The band's A side was called It's Gonna Be Morning. The B-side was called I Wanna Hear You Say Yeah.
Cause you never seem to look my way. Say the things I wanna hear you say, like yeah. I wanna hear you say yeah.
The disc was released on the 1st of August 1966 on OWL. The Hi-Fis had already started playing their regular gigs for Ayr Ice Rink and would now promote their songs on stage alongside the chart-topping groups due to perform in the town. The local press presented an excellent page each week on all the entertainment on offer throughout the town in their weekly spread. Here are a few wonderful memories via the Ayrshire Post newspaper which Eddie kept. The Troggs first came to Ayr Ice Rink on Wednesday the 15th of June 1966. The Kinks, who had appeared in Ayr in 1965, returned to the ice rink on the 30th of July 1966. They were supported by the Hi-Fis, but also by another three bands, the Vikings, the Meridians and the Red Hawks. The Kinks were that very week top of the charts with their song, Sunny Afternoon. As can be seen from the Ayrshire Post entertainment pages, Ayr nightclubs in general, attracted many of the top names in UK pop history to the town back in 1966. And here, finally, is a reminder of some of the local bands who supported the headline acts during the Swinging Sixties. Edward continued to play with his band the Hi-Fi Combo, until the end of 1966. Both Eddie and Radio Scotland then left the pop music business. Edward returned to his nursing studies. However, in the space of just 18 months, he had gone from playing the songs of the Troggs and the Kinks, plus many more, on the Ballard Mile staff canteen jukebox to actually sharing a dressing room and that big Ayr Ice Rink stage with those stars. Yes. Nostalgia is not what it used to be. Bye for now.